There's something that's inspirational when you see something great for the first time. And I had that experience with John Mohr, but truthfully, I get it every time I watch John Mohr fly.
First time I ever saw John Mohr fly was in 1987 in Rochester, Minnesota, and I'll never forget it because I didn't believe it. I just couldn't believe that anybody could fly a plane that well, that low, that consistent, and I've been watching him ever since for about 22 years. He flies just as good or better and still blows my mind every time I watch him fly.
Sun and Fun 1999, the first time I ever flew at Sun and Fun. I was standing beside Danielle and Montana, the French Connection, and I'm standing there with my mouth wide open, not believing what I'm seeing, and I look over at Montana and she says, "Yeah, we all felt that way the first time, but you get used to it after a while."
First time I saw John fly the Stearman, especially the slip that he does a foot off the ground, it raised the hair on the back of my neck. And it's one of the few that I still watch today, and it still has the same effect.
And nobody does it better. Though sometimes I wish someone could. Nobody does it.
John Mohr? John Mohr? probably one of the most finesseful pilots in the world. And when you watch John fly, and he's got his faded out blue shirt rippling in the wind and his open cockpit Stearman, and the way he flies, you go, there's an icon. There's somebody who loves the magic of flight, who loves sharing it, who is totally in love with the art form of barnstorming.
Get as low as he gets high.